For some odd reason, the fish scale braid is not often used to wrap around objects. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you the fish scale braid because I think it is a easy and efficient way to wrap objects around, and you can combine it with other braids to get some nice effects. First thing we're going to do is get an object that we want to wrap around, some cord onto which I've attached a lacing needle, and we're going to wrap it around one time, basically placing our working end over our standing end. With our lacing needle, we're going to go under the standing end and pull the cord out. And what we're going to do for the entire braid is basically coil one row onto the other, making a spiral around the previous row. So the previous row in this case is the standing end, and we're going to coil our paracord around it until we reach a second row. Once you reach the standing end, you begin a new row, and you need to find where your working cord was on this row, so you don't start under the standing end, but under the row that we just made. So this was the first row, and this is the second one. We're going to start here again. And you're going to notice that your cords basically line up and they double up when you do the second row. This may be a bit confusing, at least it was for me, but this is the way it is done. You can see here that the cords are doubled, and this is nothing to be worried about. Once you again reach the starting position, you're going to notice that your cords are doubled, and at this point, all we're going to do is split them using the same technique that we used before. Going under, pulling it through the front. Because it is quite obvious that all we're doing now is splitting, the braiding will start to go really fast. I will continue this braid until I've done a few rows, so I can show you how the braid looks like in person. And I'll be back in a second. I've done a few rows of the fish scale braid and it does look quite nice. But if I find my starting position and I pull out the slack, it's going to become an even nicer braid. So I'm going to do that until I reach the bottom, where I'm going to pull out the slack, and I will be back in a moment to show you the end result. So guys, this is how the braid looks like when it's retightened. Thank you for joining me in this tutorial. See you next time.